Amy Butler. I'm a research physicist at NOAA in the Chemical Sciences Laboratory.
Why does it get so cold in the winter?
So the first reason is because of the seasons. And you might guess that the Earth is warmer in summer because it's closer to the sun and colder in winter because it's farther away, but that's actually incorrect. The Earth is actually farthest from the sun in July. So we have seasons because the Earth is tilted on its axis as it circles around the sun. And this means that during some times of the year, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun so that it gets more direct sunlight and is warmer. So this is our summer. As the Earth keeps rotating around the sun, the northern hemisphere starts to tilt away from the sun and we get less sunlight, and this is our winter. So you might have noticed this effect because the sun does not get as high in the sky during winter as it does during summer. Because of this difference in temperature, due to the Earth receiving more heat at the equator than the pole, plus the rotation of the Earth drives the major air currents on our planet. And so the jet stream is a band of winds that forms, and it marks the boundary between warm and cold air masses or weather systems. And this band of winds is typically strongest 5 to 9 miles above Earth's surface. And the reason that it's important for cold weather is that when the northern hemisphere jet stream moves south, it allows cold air from close to the pole to come south as well. And if the jet stream swings really far south, it allows air that's been sitting over the Arctic to come pouring down into the mid-latitudes. The polar vortex, similar to the jet stream, is also a band of winds, but it's not the same thing as the jet stream. It's much higher up in the atmosphere. It only flows during winter. But it's important because sometimes the polar vortex can sort of nudge the jet stream, and this allows the jet stream again to bring cold Arctic air down south. And so sometimes you might hear of a polar vortex coming that's going to make things very cold. And what's really happening is the polar vortex winds are slowing way down, and this is driving the jet stream south. And so this is why sometimes the weather can be really, really cold.